Well, anyways,
Maybe you can just give like 10 or 20 second introduction and then you can start with your questions.
Yeah, I'm just saying about myself something. Like, my name is SambitPhD. I just finished my master's from TU Darmstadt, Germany. Mm-hmm. And my transcripts are yet not ready, like the final transcript, but I graduated already, you can say. The official process is going on to dematriculate me.
So it's the master's, right?
Yeah, I completed my master's, yeah.
And how long was it? 1.5 or 2 years?
In Germany, it was I took it like 3 years. Have you checked the facility or something, like faculty, what I sent you?
No. It's in the embedded network systems.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I know this guy. What is his name? Fernando Kripas. I know this guy. I took one of his course. He was teaching HPD, High Performance Data Networking. He was teaching this course in computer science. I took his course and that guy is like a, how do you say, that PhD will be under that guy, or
how is the importance given to the publication? Like,
so the thing is, I want to make a video on that also later. Like, that's a very misconception with many people. So ideally, in all Dutch universities now, in this present duration, it's like 4 is the max. Like, they expect 4 publication. That varies. This thing varies from all faculties, but this is like a general quality control. If an experienced person is there, he will say you this. They don't. Some people don't say it clearly, but it's 4. So 4, few years back, it was like 4 must be in journals, which is really, really difficult unless you are really working hard. And there are many other factors that go into this. So nowadays, whatever I know, your supervisor, they have a list of conferences or the journals you should go for, depending on the impact factor and other things. So in our case also, like whatever they said, even if you go for a conference, if it is a really good conference, because they will tell you beforehand when you suggest some names or they suggest you, then it's fine. So if you have like 2 journals and 2 for those top conferences, then also it is fine. So it should not be like 4. Then it becomes very easy. So ideally, they want a mix. It should not be like 4 conferences and at the end of 4, you don't have a journal. So that's the max expectation that they have. So I don't think that will put much pressure, because earlier it was like 6 or something. 3-4 years back, it was a different rule. But now they have tried to tone it down, like the expectation and the...
It's a very, very tough job.
Yeah. And this also varies. Why I said, because I have seen people after I joined this university, any Dutch university go, the rule is same. So when people graduated now, there are some people who had only 2 publications and the third was like on the process, it was pending. So that also happens, like sometimes 3, and the supervisor also knows that he has struggled a lot and there are some issues with the experiment and so he could not do or something, and they are very happy. So at the end of the day, it's like 90% of the time what I feel, your supervisor, if he's okay, he will convince anyone for you. Like, he should be happy. I mean, the main person who is supervising your thesis or the promoter or the supervisor, that person should be really happy. Like, so he can bend the rules depending on how they can, like maybe 3 publication and then back. So that's not important.
TU Darmstadt is really tough, actually. They always push for going for a publication. So everybody, I have been working with them, I know. Everybody is always working hard to get a publication or get a conference.
Yeah, I mean, they will say that, but the thing, and another advantage in TU Delft is like you have this, most faculties nowadays I've seen, like when you work with different partners, sometimes what happens, like, I mean, what I said is like a first author paper. So sometimes it might be like you have like 2 first author papers and maybe 3-4 second or third author papers. So it's not like second or third author papers are completely zero. It's like you, so in that way also they balance it out. It's like sometimes you have so many collaboration that you work little bit, but you find so many other ideas. And that's why I said, like, when you, I mean, TU Delft reputation is so good, so you get these external partners, sometimes companies, sometimes some universities. In our faculty, I know there are some PhDs from Switzerland, so they had some projects here and there was collaboration, and some PhDs in 1 year have like 4 publications, which is not possible on an individual person. So that's why I don't think that's an issue. I mean, once you are okay with it, you enjoy it, you will go with it. Like sometimes some people in 2 years have one publication and then they have like 3 more in 1 year. Sometimes, I mean, the trajectory of every PhD is completely different and it varies depending on your project and everything. So that is not possible to compare in any ways.
Yeah, of course, I understand that. Actually, you gave me the answer of the 4th question. My 3rd question was like, is there any requirement for selecting for a PhD position that the master student should have of publications already or something like that? Because I don't have any publication. I wrote a paper, but...
No, normally they like, I mean, most positions also, I don't know what was written here, but they write there that is recommended. They never mention that they need it for sure. So because some applicants in the pool, they might not have this experience also, but they might have worked in some projects and they might now know some software or programming experience, which is more relevant for that PhD. So I think it's not that not that important that you don't have a publication or like that.
I already passed. I am not looking for PhD, but I had a thought when I started my master. So after seeing this position, I got so interested. That's why I searched for you and I just pinged you if you have some knowledge. I have to require information from you. Okay. So,
but how did you find me? Because I asked some people, like, do they find in Quora or do they find in LinkedIn or do they find in YouTube or, I mean, like...
No, if I say my process, I told you I was actually looking for research positions, not actually PhD positions, but research position that is going in different companies. And I found this position and then I searched for, like, what is...
PhD in Netherlands.
Yeah, no, the faculties of that particular position.
Okay.
Then I found your answer that you are already a PhD student in Delft from Quora. Then I searched you in LinkedIn and then.
Because I have seen that the Quora, I mean, I'm writing in Quora for 2 years already, but I've seen that advertising about these things and answering the questions in Quora also reaches to many people. Like,
obviously. That's how I found you, actually. But anyways, I really got so much of information from you today. And other than these things, I also want to...